Ziggy has less refined tastes. When he finishes with the cereal, he'll probably polish off the box it came in.
Mmm, delicious. And loaded with fiber. Mmm, can't get too much fiber. Ooh. Mmm.
These baboons always figure out a way to get their grub, no matter how elusive it might be. But one thing is certain. For this troop, all food is fast food, because these baboons never know when a rival will show up to try to share what they found. So while in the big baboon house, each and every one of them eats what they can, when they can. And the most clever ones, like Cheeky, always try to save a little something for a rainy day. Of course, a lifestyle of continuous eating comes with a dark side, a very dark side. And as a result, the big baboon house is becoming filled with a whole lot of baboon bombs. These baboons drop more bombs than a B-52. Even though this luxury pad has indoor plumbing, the troop doesn't seem to care for modern conveniences. But in this house, there's no shame in dropping a deuce right in front of your neighbor. The baboons just see it as a bio break. You'd think that baboons drop bombs just because they have to go, when really, it can mean something completely different, as you will see in the Baboon Britannica.
If there are lots of baboons in your house, I regret to say you're gonna be stuck with carpets, walls, full of feces and urine. And the reason for that is when there's lots of them in, there's a huge amount of competition. It's a dangerous place to be. You've got jackpot food resources like a tin of peanut butter, and you wanna get it in the alpha males then. Whatever you do get, you could be attacked. So the juveniles tend to defecate and urinate in fear and bounce off the walls and chase one another around. And that's why you can get a situation where you walk into your house and it has been destroyed.
By day's end, the big baboon house looks like, well, like baboons live there.